So if you go into the build, you can either file, edit, gear, what have you. So you can import, you can edit things. Here's what I use. So top to left to right, okay? I never really use Lamania preview mode whenever there's Lamania. Like, oh, I use it when there's Lamania, but most of the time I don't. I don't ever use this button, and I don't really ever use this button either. If you accidentally ignore something, you can click share, show ignored items and let it show back up, which is an option. Breakdowns. This is for just looking at the stat numbers on the side of the screen. Enhancement points. Pretty self-explanatory. It's your enhancements. If you're missing any, you can just click down here. So do you want to see Horizon Walker? Do you want to see Inquisitive Tree? Or do you want to see some of the ones that we came up on Dungeon Developer Insights, like the Oakheart Tree, which is a theory-crafted tree in which you can get Constitution to hit and damage with wooden shields, or you can get Oakheart where you can wear docents regardless of what your race is, or you have a Woodwode form. Again, that's all there. You want to take a look at that. Epic Destinies. Self-explanatory. These are the Epic Destinies. Make sure you click all of them, because you get Fate points, or Epic Destiny points, when you click each Epic Destiny, so make sure you click each one. Equipment. Again, very self-explanatory. This is the equipment screen. Want to add an item? Click the slot. It loads, and then once it's loaded, you have all the items, and you click the item you want. Then, once you get an item like the 13, if it's an augment slot, you just need to find the augment you want, and then put all the augments in. Right? So pretty straightforward. Also, it has a search option. So what I will oftentimes do is, for doing a whole gear set, if I know what I want generally, I will click the center, which is find gear, which allows you to equip multiple items at a time. And it takes a while to load up. But then I can have it load up literally every item in the entire game and say I can use part of the family like so. And now I only have the part of the family items showing up. And I can just go, oh, I'm going to wear part of the family. So add by using equip. Stuff like that. So that's how you use that. Now let's say I want to make a new gear set real quick. If I press this button here, it'll make a new gear set. If I want to copy this gear set and make a slight tweak, say I want to include trapping, I click copy, then I click paste, and I go trap. And now I have two gear sets that I can flip between. And on the trap gear set, I can replace my goggles with legendary green steel. With intelligence skills. And now I have my trapping set, which is just slightly different. And I can see I have 122 disable, 122 search. Wowzers. That's an option. Then we have the level up screen. I only use this screen to get to the skills dialogue to set up your skills. This is pretty self-explanatory. You click to spend the skills. You can either max it. If I click a skill and then I press max, it'll spend all the points in it. And you can just kind of do that. Pretty straightforward. Click it around. Then you next to that, you have Reaper Tree. This is for Reaper mode. Self-explanatory, because that's what's in the game. Next to that, I think the ordering up here could stand to be different. I think that's more the issue. But then we have the Past Lives feat. If you want to add Past Lives, you just click the ones you want to add. No problem. Click it. Click to go up. Right click to go down. Very easy. Do you want to add all of the racial lives because you have all of them? Don't click 100 times. Click on the word racial. Click. 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 Hey guys, I'm a triple racial completionist. And all it took was 3 clicks. Isn't that amazing? And now if I want to remove it, right click, right click, right click. And it's the same thing. Easy. That's why all these have one. You just click it across. This is also where you would add your Tomes of Destiny, your Universal Action Point Tomes, and your Racial Point Tomes are also here. Since when? For like ever. So that's why when I want to make a new character, I'll usually just click once in Heroic to make sure I have Completionist available so my stats will be correct because I don't care about the individuals of some of the things. Next we have the spells. Self-explanatory. Click it to pick the spells. I don't really need to explain that one. Next, we have stances. Stances are the toggles your character is using. So, for example, if I'm using Ocean Stance, it'll put that on. And you can set up the abilities your character would have. So you can emulate what your character would be like if you're actually in combat. So you can kind of put all of these pieces together. Reminder that you can only have one arcane, martial, primal, and divine stance, one iconic stance active, and one mantle active, as well as one imbue. These are all mutually exclusive, so you can only pick one. And then you can go through all the stances. So I can be like, oh, I'm in Orchidium, which is my purple stance on Alchemist. So therefore, I have 214 PRR. But I could, what if I'm spiking? Well, if I'm spiking, I have 284. So I can see the difference. You can see it there. Same thing. Am I in Reaper or am I out of Reaper? You can turn that on and off. Next, we have one of the more confusing ones, which is the party buffs. This is the menu where you set all the buffs for your character. So you go, oh yeah, my character has Bless. Turn on Bless because I cast it. Oh yeah, my character, I have freedom of movement. Oh, my character also has greater heroism. That's where you put all of these things. So you would click them and put them in here of the buffs you would have. If you don't know what a buff is, you can Google it because the word is there. Notes is where you write notes for yourself in the past. There's also DCs. And DCs is where you see all your DCs for all your various abilities. It doesn't include everything. It's mostly just spell-like abilities and tactics and stuff. So like my everything is nothing is 100 right here as an example. So I can see that. And then lastly, we have the class and levels, which is the one at the end. Oh, what's this one? There's an individual skill window? Then that means I never, ever need to use this window ever. Amazing. I didn't even know this was an option. Wow. Look at that. And then... So that's cool. And then here, you have your class and levels. So to set up your classes, you just click these little drop-down arrows and click the classes that you want. And then to move one level from one to an X, you just click the spot. So if I'm on Monk 3 and I'm like, oh, actually, I need that to be Alchemist, I just go to 3 and click this space and it'll move it over. I'm not doing that because it'll destroy my file. But yeah. If you want to add in a feat, you click it. And then you scroll somewhere and you go, point blank shot. Very cool. I do want to have point blank shot. And you click the feat there. But let's say you're like, oh, I kind of want to have like, maybe I want to take quicken or something else. The trick is instead of clicking it, you middle click using the middle mouse button. And then if I say, maybe I'll take power attack, now it gives you an alternative. So the alternatives is by middle clicking. And let's say there's a feat you never want to see, and you're like, you know what? I never want to see stealthy. This is useless. You right click it, and it disappears. It now hides that from you, so you can never see the stealthy feat ever again. Now let's say accidentally you clicked, and you're like, yeah, you know what? Snake blood, that's dumb. Click it, and you go, wait, no, I need snake blood. It's my favorite feat. I gotta see snake blood again, and it's gone forever. It's not gone forever. What you do is you go up here to the show ignored items list, click it up, then go back to your feats. Now you can see everything that you've ignored. And then I go, okay, snake blood, right click. And now it's going to be unignored. So then when I go back to the menu, I can see I have snake blood back on the list. So keep that in mind. And that's about it. If a feat is not showing up on the list, that's probably because you forgot the requirements. Make sure you set up your base stats. If you have tomes, what your level ups are, and your alignments. You might be like, huh, I can't see single weapon fighting in the builder. I don't get it. That's because single weapon fighting requires balance. So if you forgot to put the skills in and you forgot to put balance, then you won't see single weapon fighting in the builder. And that's basically everything you need to know. So how do I start a character? Name, race, alignment, put in the base stats that you're going to need, your tomes or whatever, and what you're going to do on your level up. Then I hit this button and choose my class and levels. So I figure what the levels are. Then if I need feats that require skills, like single weapon fighting, I would do skills immediately after that. And if it doesn't, then I just kind of go through and do all of the feats. And then after that, I go through and do all of the enhancements. Then I do the epic destinies. Then I usually fill in with the spells. If it's a brand new file, you can put in your past life feats. What I recommend is if you like doing the past lives on your characters, you're doing multiple past lives, what I would do here is make a template. So build like a template file that happens to have your past lives on your character or what have you, and then just have that as your baseline so you can update that in the future. So you don't have to like start from scratch every single time, which is also a good way to do it. So yeah. Yeah, and then you select your classes near your feet. So you select classes up at the top here. You can also use show all so you can see the missing requirements true. So if you don't have the prerequisite, you can just click show all, and then you'll be able to see things you don't have the requirements for. Right? So if I go to level 1, you'll notice I don't have two-handed fighting on the list because I don't have the strength for it. But if I click the red button, show requirements, or like ignore requirements, then I go, okay, cool, two-handed fighting. You know, why wasn't it showing up? Mouse over, and it even tells you, requires strength 15, requires none of single weapon fighting. So you can see why you don't have it. It's highlighted in red. Okay. So that's there and fixed for you. I think I set that up, right? No, I did not. Turn off. And then once I've got the past lives and everything else sorted out, then I like to do stances, sort out my stances and how my character is going. So make sure to turn on your mantles, turn on like, you know, precision, make sure you're in your monk stance, stuff like that. It's, if it's on, it has a blue border. If it's off, it doesn't have a blue border. It should be pretty self-explanatory. Make sure to set up your spells. Important note when it comes to spells, if the spells have if it's a buff spell, they'll auto apply to your character. So for example, because I'm using this ability here, so Greater Evolution, it gives me +4 to a stat. Actually, Greater Evolution is a bad example because I have to apply it with the buffs because I have to like basically put it in. But let's just say another example, like Bless, right? So if I put the Bless spell in here or one of these other abilities, like Stiffen Skin, if I put Stiffen Skin in here, my armor class is going to automatically go up because it's going to start accounting for the fact that I just put stiffened skin in. So your spells will automatically apply. Right? So it goes over my camera. Oh, it does? That's hilarious. I'm going to move this over here. I move that. Thank you for the reminder. Appreciate it. It's okay. Buy Rogue Energy. Does it show auto-granted feats from classes? Yes, it will show you other granted feats. That's what this green menu is for. The green menu will show you the feats that you're granted at each individual level. And when they're auto-granted. So you can see automatic feats are here. So level 1, I get spiked chain. Level 2, I get all the monk feats here at granted. Level 3, I can see I get evasion as an example. And you can see that in the green button. I never click the green button, but this you can go level by level and see what you get at each level. That being said, though, it won't, if you're going to get like, let's say you're like, oh, you pick like rogue here and then monk here, whatever, or like, let's say this monk is ranger, where you would get two weapon fighting at level 3. It's going to show you two weapon fighting here as your level 1 feat selection, even though you would get it for free later, because that's how it works in game, because the game doesn't know what you're going to do in the future. So just be careful about that. Just pay attention. And then last, or second last, I do equipment. So then I go through and I set up the equipment. To add filigrees, you just tell it how many you have. Okay, so you say, you like, oh, I have 10 on my weapon. Perfect. It adds an extra slot. You can pick a sentient jewel, but it doesn't matter because it has no stats. And then when it comes to the filigrees, you can either use the menu or not menu. I use the menu, where when you click it, it pulls up all the filigrees based on their category. So let's say you want to use Embrace by Light, I can throw it in here. If you click off of this menu, when you click it instead, it's just a drop down and you can scroll through to the one that you want. So if you're more of a visual person, maybe this helps better for you because you can see the colors in the images. For me, I like the menu because it's an alphabetical. So I go, okay, I need purity here. And I click it in and then boom, now I have it. To remove anything on the equipment screen, you right click and it removes stuff from the actual equipment, so I can remove an item. So if I want to remove a filigree set, so I would just go charisma here, I can remove it by right clicking, and then all of a sudden it is gone. And then last but not least, is the buffs. As I said, I then apply buffs afterwards. So let's just say I'm playing this character, the alchemist. I would go down the list. Okay, I don't have a bard with me. You know, I don't have bless, I don't have blur, I do have displacement, so I'm gonna apply displacement. I don't have any of this other stuff. I do cast greater heroism on myself, so I'll put that on. I do cast haste on myself. I do cast jump. Long lasting potions, these are store potions or the ones you get from remnants. So I go, okay, I am going to use a remnant potion. So I'll keep that up because it's in my in-game character. I'm going to use the remnant potions, no problem. Don't mind that. I have night shield, so I'm going to put that one on. Keep going down the list. I don't have prayer. I don't have rage. I don't have shield. I don't have any of this stuff. And then the Ugaloth potions are all the way at the bottom. They're currently covered up by Rogue, but you have the Ugaloth potions all the way at the bottom. So then once I've got all that stuff sorted out, I go, okay, cool, that's done. And then you can start looking through all of your abilities. Make sure some of these numbers might be wrong. Double check and go, oh, intelligence 82, that's weird. Oh, make sure you turn on guild buffs and set the level of your guild, and it'll give you the buffs appropriate to that. So to make sure you have it on there. And then it has a breakdown. So you can see if I click intelligence, you can see my whole breakdown of where each stat individually comes from. If I have stuff that doesn't stack, the game will actually tell me. So I go armor class and I can see... actually, these all, nothing here is non-stacking. There's something that doesn't stack. Where I have multiple times. Double strike, maybe? Perfect. So then I can see double strike. You can see that when I clicked it, it tells me all my sources and what type of bonus there is for each one. So you can see the type of bonus. And then you can see, oh, inactive. Azamar Scourge past life, I didn't turn that on. Wind stance, I don't have it turned on. And then non-stacking, my augment in my cloak doesn't stack with my Flame Guard's lenses. So I know that now, and I can go, oh, that's extra items. Maybe I don't need that. Also, the builder will sometimes have bugs. But yeah, and then it breaks down everything for you, so all your stats. As far as the stats go, abilities, your main scores, saving throws, your saves, skills, your skills, physical breakdowns. That's incoming and outgoing, physical. So incoming is your hit points and your defenses. This also has your armor class in it, so you can see your armor class here, any percent bonuses you have, as well as your maximum dex bonus. Your magic resistance with the cap, because everyone has an MRR cap if you have 50 for cloth and 100 for light armor. And then your dodge, as well as your dodge cap, if you change that, your incorporeality and your displacement, again, it's all there. As far as your offensive breakdowns, this is your offensive physical damage, so melee ranged characters, double strike, imbued ice, sneak attack damage, which is like deception items, sneak attack attack, which is again deception items, melee power, range power, double shot, fort bypass, all that stuff is all here. Tactical breakdowns, your tactical DCs, like I'm a stunner, so I got my stun DCs here. Key, if you want to keep track of how much key you get. Magical breakdowns is, again, magic. It's pretty self-explanatory. How much mana do you have? Where does it come from? What bonuses do you get to each spell school? What's your crit multi? What's your spell power? Crit chance? All that stuff is there if you want to calculate it out. So all these things are here. And then at the end, you have the weapon bonus. Your hit chance, your damage. I've found that the hit chance is usually off by about 10. I don't exactly know why, but it's usually off by about 10. So it is what it is. And that's it. So that's pretty much how to use this program. Last but not least, if you want to share it with others, when you save it, it creates a file and you can give that to other people. Pro tips when saving files that you want to give to others, be clear in the title of what it is and when you're going to be sharing it with somebody. So that's important. Also, if you're going to be sharing it with others, you may include, if you want, the actual version in the file, because when you download this builder, like the Matron Builder, he puts it out in different versions, so you'll be able to download it at that point. So just keep that in mind. So that way you can be like, oh, somebody can find the build and be like, oh, this is an older build or it's a different version or something, because there might be bugs, which may something that you may want to do as well. But yeah, so all of that is kind of, you know, kind of in there. And then finally, if you want to export it and share it with someone, you can just export to clipboard. So then you can like set what you want on or off. So you're all there, so you can just, you know, put like, oh, when I share my builds, this is what I use as the default, like simple gear and stuff like that. So I can just quickly copy and paste it out of here. Something a lot of people don't know, you don't have to copy all of this. When you click OK, it automatically adds it to your clipboard. So then you can just paste. So you can just paste it with Control V and you're all set. Did I mention the notes tab? I hoped so, but in case you didn't realize this is notes. You can write notes for yourself or other people for later. It's very cool. And that's pretty much it. If you have any other questions about the builder, or you get confused about something that wasn't explained here, then I guess I'm turning this into a YouTube video, so write a comment? But that's pretty much it. Wait, you want me to right-click the taskbar? Why? Oh yeah, because you can customize and get rid of stuff if you want. So you can add or remove certain things, so what's on the toolbar? Yeah, so you can customize some stuff. You don't have to do this, but you can if you want. And change what you can see in all these different areas. So there are more options, of course, but I don't really do with any of that. So yeah. Anyway, that's pretty much it. Go out there, build your characters, have fun. And then enjoy yourself. Also, yeah, if you want to get rid of stuff, you can also do that too. There technically is a dark mode here. Application look, there is a... There, you can change the visuals of it. Black style. but there's no real dark mode. Dark mode is in the new DDO builder being put together by Matrim.